vast majority of patients that get leukemia, the actual cause is unknown. We do understand what's broken. It's a very, very common question, as you might imagine. We do understand what breaks, but we don't know why it breaks. As if you took your car in and they said, you know, the fuel pump is broken. And you go, but why did the fuel pump break? And you don't know. And the mechanic goes, I don't know. Excuse me. We now know, for example, many, many different genetic abnormalities. And by genetic abnormalities, I don't mean genetic abnormalities that you inherit from your mom and dad or that you pass to your children. These are genetic abnormalities of the cancer cell, of the leukemia cell. So we've been able to find these differences that lead to different leukemias. So we know the difference between a functioning fuel pump and a bad fuel pump, but we don't know why it broke. And there we do know some things, exposures to hydrocarbons, like fuels, exposure to radiation. But again, the majority of the patients that we see don't have that sort of history. And they're really, again, we can do molecular tests and we can say, these are the characteristics of your leukemia. This is why it's behaving this way. We've even gotten to the point where we can subdivide the acute leukemias into those that we regard as relatively good risk and bad risk. The bad risk ones are the ones that we're going to want to transplant sooner rather than later. But we still don't know why. So we know the what, but we don't know the why.